The son of former New South Wales Premier Christina Keneally today avoided jail after the ex-policeman was found guilty of fabricating evidence which wrongfully put a man in jail. But the case is still far from over, with the 25-year-old determined to clear his name.
His false allegations sent a man to prison. Today this criminal cop avoided the same fate.
Daniel, why did you fabricate evidence?
Daniel Keneally, the son of former Premier Christina Keneally, was a rookie policeman when he took a phone call from activist Luke Moore in February 2021.
What's the company you represent?
Mate, I'm CEO and founder of isuepolice.com.
The conversation went on for 12 minutes, the officer not aware it was being recorded. Keneally then later accused the self-styled justice warrior of threatening to kill a detective after reading comments he'd made online. Moore was arrested days later.
I actually got arrested in the park, and it was my missus and child who were here at home when six armed cops showed up to raid the house.
Moore was eventually released after 3 weeks in custody when it was clear the officer's evidence didn't stack up.
When people like Keneally are entrusted with the sort of power and authority that police officers are, when they breach and break that trust, the consequences should be severe and justice should be swift.
In sentencing, the magistrate said there was significant damage to the victim given his time spent in custody. He told Keneally, "You have lost your career, you didn't plan it. You were an inexperienced and junior police officer and had no apparent motive."
For a charge which carries a maximum penalty of 10 years imprisonment, Mr. Keneally was sentenced to 15 months to be served in the community. He must also carry out 200 hours of community service and pay a $2,000 fine.
Well, there's expert evidence to show how fallible the mind can be. You, me, everybody, we all make mistakes. The matter's far from over, and my client maintains his innocence.
An appeal to fight the conviction has already been lodged. Hayley Francis, Nine News.